everyone with the Westfall alma mater.
And now please honk your horns and give a warm welcome to your senior class president, Mr. Justin Schoblock, as he leads you in the Pledge of Allegiance one final time.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now please give a warm welcome and honk your horns for this year's special guest speaker, Mr. Billy Dennis. Parents, family members, friends, students, guests, and graduates, good evening. I am Billy Dennis, principal of Westfall High School. I'd like to welcome you and everyone to the 56th commencement exercises of the Westfall Local School District and extend to you a warm and appropriately socially distanced welcome. Graduates, almost more than any other thus far in your lives, this day is one of reflection, a time of reflecting on these last 13 years. For what always seemed like a distant, distant day has finally arrived. Although probably not quite the way you pictured it, you've made it. Here you sit, the 56th graduating class of Westfall High School, ready to drive off into your future. From here, each of you will travel your own path. But don't just follow that path. Be the driving force for where that path leads. Forge ahead, knowing that you have completed an education which will help you unlock many doors. But before you step through any of those doors, spend some time reflecting. Reflecting on all the time you spent talking to each other. Reflecting on all the time you spent laughing with each other. Reflecting on all the time you spent experiencing life over these last 13 years with each other. Life with these people who surround you, again, at an appropriate social distance, of course. These, your classmates, your fellow graduates, your friends. Little did any of you know that March 12th, 2020 was the last time you'd be gathered together as a senior class. Undoubtedly, in the spirit of reflection, your parents and family are sitting here reflecting too. They are reflecting on the first time they put you on that bus. And I bet you they even remember what your backpack looked like. Yet, here they sit wondering the same thing. How did this happen so quickly? In the blink of an eye, you went from kindergartner to graduate. You are about to follow in the footsteps of nearly 7,000 that have crossed before you, but none have done it quite like you have. As you prepare to move forward with your lives, two words keep coming to my mind, which will define this class for the rest of my career: resilience and perseverance. You faced a senior year like no other. The definition of perseverance is persistence in doing something despite difficulty or delay in achieving success. Difficulty may be an understatement, considering how this year ended. But even though this year looks much different than any of us could have imagined, you've made it your own. You've continued your studies, you achieved in the face of overwhelming odds, and you have had quite possibly the most unique ending ever to a senior year. Even with all of this, and all of your in-person classes canceled, your concerts canceled, your sporting events canceled, and all of your social events being canceled, you have persevered. And no matter where you go from here or what you do, there are challenges ahead. Reflect on the challenges of these last few months and rest assured in the fact that you have what it takes to meet those challenges head on and continue to persevere. Wake up tomorrow. Well, maybe you should wait till Tuesday, and then focus on where you go next. Have faith. Have the faith that I do in you, that you can do whatever you want, whatever you set your minds to. But as for resilience, look at what you have already accomplished so far, even after having faced this difficult ending to your high school career. At least three of you are joining the branch of the military: Jaden Hall with the United States Marine Corps, Wade Hall, the United States Marine Corps, and William Morris, Army National Guard. Among you sit students who have accumulated nearly $1 million in scholarships and awards. 40 of you have maintained a cumulative GPA of 3.5 or better. 61 of you have a senior GPA of 3.0 or better. And 40 of those have held that GPA for all 4 years. 48 of you are wearing honor cords. There are students that will be entering colleges as sophomores and even juniors. Students have earned their career technical certificates, which will let them go right into the workforce. Other students who will be entering the workforce right away. Other students have earned their workforce readiness seals. Students who are attending 2- and 4-year college and technical programs. You have accomplished all of this in the face of a crippling worldwide event, and you've already proven your resilience to us here at Westfall. Now, I want you to go and prove it to the rest of the world. I hope your lives after Westfall bring you everything you want. Well, almost everything, with the exception of just one. That way, you always have something to dream of. And as you close the book on your time here at Westfall and transition from a time of reflection to a time of setting your sights on the future, remember these simple words from Abraham Lincoln: whatever you are, be a good one. Congratulations, class of 2020, and good luck.
Thank you, Mr. Dennis, for those kind remarks.
And one more time, honk your horns and welcome Justin Schoblock back to the stage as he presents your class history.
Thank you, Mr. Dennis. I would like to take my time to look back on our past, talk about what we missed, and leave you with a positive mindset for the future. Our journey all started at Westfall Elementary School. What animal were you? A Clifford? A bear? A frog? Kindergarten was our first year in the Green Wing, where animals represented our classrooms and our buses. I was a red Clifford. What were you? We learned to say the Pledge of Allegiance and had the luxury of bathrooms in our classroom. First grade came, and little did we know, the picture books we were reading would soon become chapter books and biographies. In second grade, our behavior was reflected by clips moving up and down. In third grade, lunch and recess were the best part of the day. I remember teachers saying, "You must cast your ketchup packet around the table at least once before I'll cut it for you." The Spotlight Cafe was the new 5-star restaurant, and we all wanted to eat at, and magnificent Mustangs were our lottery tickets. Fourth grade is when we began to switch classes. This small step of freedom was about to become the new normal for our next 9 years at Westfall. Wow. I thought elementary school would never end. We had reached the end of the Red Wing. Our fifth grade year is when technology started to play a massive role in our education. We knew what was up back then. Cool math. That's right. If you weren't playing Run 2, then you were definitely changing the outfit on your Papa Tropica character. We now moved on to Fearson Pike. Sixth grade was scary because everything was new. But nothing was more frightening than Miss Sowers in the locker area. Seventh grade, there was no more monkey bars, no swings, it was four square. Eighth grade flew by with eighth grade dance and DC trip. It was the end of another chapter. And finally, boom, Westfall High School. Where's Miss Oni's room? Am I gonna make it to class on time? Is Mr. Dennis gonna yell at me? These were thoughts that frantically ran through our heads the first week of school. But we soon learned the only thing we needed to fear was the sound of Miss Kelly's heels in the hallway. For many of us, sophomore year was car year, adding the responsibility of getting ourselves to school and back. But once you drove, you knew who was in charge, Sheriff Miller and his sidekick, Deputy Knoll. Junior year was pure hell with our stressful workload. But I suspect many of us wish we could go back to those ordinary days with our busy schedules and seeing our friends. Senior year, we did it. Time for our final throw, our ultimate catch, and our last game. Our last concert with our last note. Our final lunch, our final laugh, our last memory, our last day, the final bell. Thursday, March 12th, 2020. Unknowingly, that is when we experienced all of our last. It was not Friday, May 20th, as expected. While the coronavirus may have canceled our prom, FFA meetings, BPA meetings, the speech competition, the musical, our banquets, state conventions, and our sports seasons, we can handle these disappointments because of the disappointments we have experienced in the past. Think about everything you've cried about over the last 13 years. The beloved teachers that have retired. The positions you didn't get. The award you didn't receive. The team you didn't make. And especially, the classmates we've lost. These heartbreaks are real life. It makes us stronger. We're not gonna let 3 months of a virus tank our lives. We are to be proud graduates of Westfall High School. We have received our diplomas and will become the next leaders of our community. So I leave you with something that one of my best teachers, Mrs. Hook, ever told me. Everything is what you make of it. Don't let the coronavirus bring you down. While we may not have experienced a natural conclusion to our senior year, let's cherish the moment the football field was lit up for us and the community members who have adopted us. Wherever our lives lead us, my wish is that we will all remember the community that has supported us throughout the years. Thank you.
Thank you, Justin.
And now please welcome a young man that has demonstrated personal and academic excellence throughout his career here at Westfall High School. I'd like to present to you this year's honor graduate, Jacob Hawks.
I would first like to take this time to thank my family that has graciously supported me, my mentors, my advisors who have helped me reach my ambitions, and the teachers who have prepared me not only for further education, but for life ahead. Over 200 individuals that each support their students make up the Westfall Local School District. Every staff member has slowly molded us into the people we are today. From the moment we walked into the door of the elementary school to now, we have learned to be courteous and respectful. We have also learned to write in cursive, which we have yet to use. We have learned our state's history, read and wrote poetry, studied chemistry, and solved plenty of math problems which we'll never need. We've already invented tape measures, so I don't think I'll ever have to measure how tall a lamppost is by its shadow. As we face and experience each individual situation within our lives, our interests change, we alter our dreams, and we create new plans. When we are young, everything we saw or heard on TV fueled our imaginations. Star Wars was my world as a kid. I remember wanting to live my life as a Jedi. Unfortunately, that was last week, and my mom told me I better grow up if I wanted to go to college. I think I got the last laugh, though, because I'm currently wearing a robe. As middle schoolers, fitting in became part of the equation. The dreams we once had were pushed away by those around us. We were afraid of the ideas we once had and that they would not fit in with the person we were supposed to be. We got caught up so much in our emotions we didn't even know who we are. Then high school rolled around. We acted like we knew what we were doing, but we definitely did not. Every other time we opened our lockers, we used our combination from middle school. High school was a time of discovery. A time to experiment with the classes we take, a time to develop our interests, have a reality check, and attempt to decide what it is we are supposed to do. Our individuality really shows in high school. There's no one left to impress except for ourselves, and maybe our parents, because college isn't cheap. Our dreams are a common theme throughout our developing lives. As kids, they're quite childish, but they are still our own dreams. As we reach the end of our high school days, some of us have our own dreams. Some of us have listened to our parents' dreams, and others have no clue what we're doing. For those of you who have your dreams set, whether you're entering the workforce, getting a degree, or serving in the country's military, I encourage you to follow your dream, as you will not be disappointed. For those of you who have listened to your parents to become the stereotypical doctor or lawyer, ask yourself if you really want to play the game of operation on real people, or be the person who actually reads user agreements for the rest of your life. If the answer is yes, then that's probably something that you would like. If not, create your own dream. It might sound like a great idea to follow your parents' dream, but it will not be too appealing when you have spent 4 years and thousands of dollars of your life on a career you don't enjoy. For those of you remaining who have no clue what to do, look at your interests, the things you get the most enjoyment from, and what you feel most rewarded from in doing. Take those ideas and create your own dream. Ideas are scary for everyone. With a little time and consideration, you will know the right future for yourself. The recent pandemic has wrecked our dream to the end of amazing senior year. We were sitting in class nearly 3 months away from this moment when it all got torn apart. Spring sports, FFA state convention, prom, the final band concert, and even this graduation. Without the blink of an eye, it was all gone. Through this trial, I think we have all learned the immense value of the time we spend with family and friends, and the time we have to do with the things that we love. 2020 is a great year, but it will not just be remembered as the year that we graduated, but for the rest of your lives, 2020 will be remembered as the year that spring break was 6 months long, the year we could not leave the house, and the year we had no toilet paper. I want to give one last thanks to everyone influential in my life and the wonderful and fantastic staff at Westfall High School.
Now please welcome Mr. Sean Ruth, Westfall Board of Education President.
Thank you for the introduction, Mr. Dennis. On behalf of the Board of Education, I'd like to welcome everyone to this unique graduation ceremony. I also want to acknowledge the individuals who work within the Westfall School District for being part of the journey for the graduating students who make up the class of 2020. Whether you're a building principal, teacher, bus driver, cook, custodian, or hold another position, each of you have played a role in the overall experience for the individuals we are here to celebrate. To the family, friends, and loved ones, thank you. Thank you for encouraging the class of 2020 to strive for success and for always being someone they can go to when in need. Without your help and dedication, it is likely that these students would not be who they are today. It is often that we underestimate the true power and influence that our families have on who we become. We can look forward to the bright futures these students have in front of them and feel proud, knowing the difference that has been made in their lives. Once again, thank you for all you have done throughout the years and for all you will do in the future. To the graduating class of 2020, I'm pretty sure if I asked each of you at the beginning of the year how your senior year would end, no one would have said you would face a global pandemic in mid-March, your high school building would close, you wouldn't have a musical, not finish winter sports, not have spring sports, not attend prom, and not have graduation on the football field. Well, unfortunately, that's exactly how this has played out. The good news is there are many things that you deserve to celebrate, and the past 2 months are a bump in the road, and you have many things to be grateful for and look forward to in the future. Graduation is a huge milestone in your life. It's the end of one journey and the beginning of a new and exciting adventure. It means that although you are leaving Westfall, you will always be a graduate of a special place. For some of you, the next adventure will be joining the workforce or continuing your education in college or trade school, or serving and protecting our country in the U.S. military. Regardless of what that next step is in your life, realize each of you will be representing your family, friends, loved ones, and yourselves as a graduate of Westfall. These unprecedented times have been difficult for many of you, and I get it. On the flip side, these unprecedented times have presented the Westfall class of 2020 with a unique perspective that few of us had so early in life. It's the perspective of truly understanding how precious life is and how none of us should take anything in life for granted. Although at times it may feel like you have little control over what happens in life, I do believe you have two important things that you can control. The first of those two things are your attitude. You have a choice, no matter how difficult or unfair a situation may seem, you can choose to have a positive attitude. Having a positive attitude means being optimistic about how the next chapter of your story is written. It's about what is possible for you versus what's impossible. If you've had more good days than bad during the past few months, then I would say you're an individual who understands the power of positivity. I don't know about you, but I know I prefer to be around people who are positive versus people who are negative. Right now, being positive can be as simple as saying hello or offering a smile. A big part of your education at Westfall was learning math and science to read and write. This part of your education typically had grades associated, and for some of you, that was exciting, and for others, like me, let's just say we should have done better. This brings me to the second thing you control, and that's your effort. Regardless of where you go next or what you do, the effort and drive you put into each day is completely up to you. We all know someone who wasn't the smartest student but received excellent grades, or maybe they weren't the most talented athlete but made the varsity team because they worked harder than others and never gave up when things got tough. The point I'm trying to make is when you combine a positive attitude with a lot of effort, you have a simple recipe for success in life. Although it's tough how things seem to have ended this year, just remember that the Westfall class of 2020 will be the most memorable class in school history and absolutely have one of the most unique stories to share with your children and grandchildren later in life. Until you get to those later chapters in your life, have a positive attitude, give maximum effort in everything you do, and try to be kind to other people. On behalf of the Board of Education, congratulations on an outstanding career here at Westfall, and best of luck in writing your next chapter. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Ruth. And now please welcome Mr. Jeff Sheets, Superintendent of the Westfall Local School District.
Thank you, Mr. Dennis. Good evening, class of 2020. As you know, it's been an extremely unusual year. You've gone through many disappointments. I'm sure you were disappointed when you found out that you would not have a traditional graduation. But I hope that as the graduation plan was laid out for you, you started seeing some advantages. If I were you, I would, in my mind, be making a list of pluses and minuses. One of my top pluses would be, well, with a virtual graduation, you won't have to sit there and listen to a bunch of people get up and talk. Yet here I am. So do me a favor, sit on the edge of your car seats and listen to what I've got to say. One of the highlights of my life and career has been getting back into education at Westfall. What I missed more than anything was being around young people. It was a thrill for me to go out in the hallway and see the people walking around the school and seeing all the good people in the hallways of Westfall, especially Westfall High School. And I think mainly of the senior class because 2020 is your year. You don't have to go far to hear somebody say, "What's wrong with kids today? What's happening in this world? Kids are so bad." I'm here to tell you that I've worked with young people for four decades, and young people today are very good. They're very good. And what I saw at Westfall were young people that was very good. The class of 2020 had many accomplishments during their senior year. One of my favorite sayings is, "What you focus on is what you see." You can focus on what you missed, and that won't bring happiness. But I would suggest that you try to focus on what you didn't miss. Of all the things and relationships you built, accomplishments in your K through 12 education. Even this year with the senior class, I've seen you excel in academics. I've seen FFA excel on the local and even national level. I've seen our instrumental and vocal music programs excel. I've seen several league championships. I've seen a golf team go to the state with a senior presence on that team. I've seen a volleyball team win the SVC with strong senior leadership. There were also many individual honors. And I would go back and mention that I didn't mention the wrestling team, who continues their domination of the SVC. Congratulations to those teams and anybody that I'm not mentioning now. There were also many individual honors. I think it's a big deal that Westfall had the top senior boy basketball player in Pickaway County. Congratulations, Jay. And I think it's a big deal that Westfall senior class had the top wrestler in Pickaway County. Congratulations, Chanston. And I was even reading a reminder this morning of Jacob Hawks receiving the Franklin B. Walter Award. The Franklin B. Walter Fund recognizes one senior from every county in Ohio, and Pickaway's county representative was Jacob Hawks. Those people were representative of the class of 2020 and of the Westfall community. The Ohio Department of Education and the Westfall School Board puts through mandatory requirements to graduate from Westfall School. You have fulfilled those requirements. You have fulfilled those requirements and more with all of your accomplishments. Do you think it's possible that you accomplish more in two-thirds of a year than many classes have in a whole year? Because I think that's what I've witnessed. In the requirements you have fulfilled, they qualify you for me to recommend you to the Westfall Board of Education as graduates for the class of 2020. Good luck always. Remember, you're always special. Remember, you're always a Mustang. Congratulations.
National Honor Society member Jordan Zachary Adams. Jordan has a 3.75 grade point average, is graduating with honors, receiving a gold honor cord, 4-year award, and honor pin. Jordan loves watching wrestling, both WWE and NXT, and moving forward with his physical therapy. Jordan is looking forward to getting a job after graduation. Jalissa Janae Arthurs. Jalissa is graduating with a 3.27 GPA, has been accepted to Columbus State Community College and Central Ohio Technical College. Her activities involve computer technology courses, Circleville softball, volunteering at the Fayette County Humane Society, shadowing volunteer work at Northcourt Animal Clinic. Jalissa is a gold honor cord and honor pin recipient. Michaela Marie Arthurs. Michaela has a 3.4 GPA, has applied to the Columbus College of Art and Design, a member of the Drug Free Club, Yearbook, FFA, Prom Committee, has shadowed nursing homes and dental assistants and a mentor. Michaela is an honor pin recipient. Peyton Lee Bockstetter. Peyton has a GPA of 3.41, attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center. Peyton is a gold honor cord and honor pin recipient and has received a Shawnee State Swimming Scholarship. National Honor Society member Amy Nicole Ball. Amy has a 3.78 GPA. She will be attending Ashland University, majoring in nursing, and participating as a member on the cheer team. Amy is in NHS, FFA, Drug Free Club, cheerleading, and 2-year student council member. She is also a gold honor cord, honor pin, and 4-year award recipient. Tyler Jacob Bowens. Tyler has a 4.0 GPA, is an honor pin recipient, has been hired to Elford, with future plans to run his own business. Thomas Arthur Bretthauer. TJ has been hired by LVLUP Sports, activities racing dirt bikes, and after high school, TJ wants to continue racing, hopefully go pro in racing, and work at a mechanic shop. Michaela Dawn Bryant. Michaela has a 3.8 GPA. She will be attending Columbus State Community College and then transferring to Ohio State University, majoring in biology. Michaela is a member of the varsity golf team, marching band, color guard, yearbook, and BPA. Michaela is a gold honor cord, honor pin, and 4-year award recipient. Patrick Stewart Bundock. Patrick has a 3.07 GPA and was a member of the varsity basketball and soccer teams. Matthew William Chester. Matt has a GPA of 3.54. Matt attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center and is a Gold Honor Cord recipient. Preston McKinley Clifton. Preston is an Honor Pin recipient. His future plans are to go to Columbus State for mechanics and work for Reichert Ford. Preston loves working on cars. It's one of the things that him and Trey always used to do together. He also likes solving problems and fixing things just like his dad. Some of his best accomplishments his senior year were receiving MVP in cross country and getting a 17:23 in the 5K. National Honor Society Honors Diploma and Readiness Seal recipient, Kimber Ann Callahan. Kimber has a 4.2 GPA, is a member of Westfall National Honor Society, DAR Good Citizen, Pickaway County Council on Youth Leadership, and gold-rated FFA chapter reporter. She was a FFA state-winning AgriSphere Plant Systems. She's a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Kimber plans to attend Columbus State Community College to study biology. Paige Alexis Coleman. Paige says, "You don't even want to know my GPA," but she will be attending CCCC for dental hygienist. The family of Trey Allen Collier. Trey was a member of the soccer team, cross country, and track. Trey will be remembered very fondly by the class of 2020 and the whole Mustang family. Hunter William Copeland. Hunter is honor roll, gold honor cord, honor pin, and four-year award recipient. Hunter attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center in law and public safety. His industry credentials are chemical mace, taser, and first aid CPR. He is a member of Skills USA and the MADE Drug-Free Club. Currently employed at FedEx Ground. Andrew Thomas Kramer. Andrew has a 3.3 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord and Honor Pin recipient. Honors Diploma recipient, Gage Allen Doherty. Gage has a 3.9 GPA, Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. He is a member of the Business Professionals of America. And after high school, he plans on going to Ohio University for either accounting or nursing. Seth Elijah Dean. Seth has a 3.05 GPA, is an Honor Pin recipient, and is undecided on what he wants to do after graduation, but he is an aspiring entrepreneur. Austin Cooper Elliott. Austin has a 3.48 GPA. He is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Richard Ellis, accepting on behalf of Casey Jackson Ellis. Casey has a GPA of 3.11 and is an Honor Pin recipient. Victoria Sage Fairchild. Victoria has a 2.69 GPA. Her future plans are undecided, but she enjoys drawing. Chase Andrew Farrell. Chase attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center. He is a member of Skills USA, and his industry credentials are automotive service excellence and student certifications of medium heavy truck electrical electronic systems, medium heavy truck diesel engines, medium heavy truck brakes, and steering and suspension. Christian Jeremiah Finnegan. Christian's activities are basketball, JV baseball, JV football. His certification is in carpentry and has been hired to Finnegan's Welding and Fab LLC as a welder fabricator. Brandon Lee Fleek. Brandon has a 3.5 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. He earned Ohio FFA state degree and has been hired to Fleek Brothers Farm Drainage. National Honor Society and Honors Diploma recipient Lillian Annabelle Fox. Lily has a 4.32 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. She will be attending Cedarville University to major in music education and minor in biblical studies. She has received many scholarships, Cedarville Chancellor's Excellence, Cedarville Soli Deo Gloria Music, Pickaway County Council on Student Leadership, and Elk's Most Valuable Student, state and local. Her activities include Battle Over Books, Marching and Jazz Band, NHS, Show Choir, Big Brothers, Big Sisters Volunteer, Buckeye Christian Church Nursery and Children's Worship Volunteer, Hope Homeless Outreach Ministry Volunteer, and musicals, where she would have been Dorothy in The Wizard of Oz. Asia Jean Follen. Asia has a 4.02 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. She is attending Columbus State Community College for the first 2 years of college and then transferring to Ohio State University. She intends to get her bachelor's degree and all 4 years will be studying radiology. Asia was in varsity softball for 4 years, National Honor Society her senior year, and joined the drug-free program her senior year. She has been in the sports medicine program at Pickaway Ross since her junior year. Heather Nicole Gibson. Heather attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center in general merchandising and warehousing. She is a member of DECA, and her industry credentials are first aid CPR, forklift operator license, and man lift operator license. Shawnee Marie Gilbert. Shawnee has a 3.58 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. She attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center in general merchandising and warehousing. She is a member of DECA and the MADE Drug Free Club. Her industry credentials are first aid CPR, forklift operator license, man lift operator license, and her activities include fishing and hiking. Jaden Lee Hall. Jaden has a 4.16 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Jaden has enlisted in the U.S. Marine Corps and will be shipping out to boot camp August 23rd. Jaden participated in varsity wrestling all 4 years of high school and was honor roll student. Wade Garrett Hall. Wade studied networking and cybersecurity for 2 years at Pickaway Ross. He is a member of BPA. His industry credentials are CompTIA Strata IT Fundamentals. And after graduation, Wade will be enlisting into the U.S. Marine Corps. He will attend online college while completing military schooling. Jaden Thomas Hammond. Jaden has a 3.3 GPA. He is an Honor Pin and four-year award recipient. Jaden will be attending Ohio University to study health sciences. Jaden is a member of the varsity football, basketball, and baseball teams, and was a yearbook ad salesman. Jetta Riley Hampson. Jetta is a member of the 4-H Club, and her future plan is to go back to school for cosmetology and start her own salon. Elizabeth Ann Hart. Elizabeth has a 3.95 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. She will be attending Columbus State Community College, double majoring in paralegal and forensic accounting. Liz was involved with varsity golf, color guard, and the yearbook. National Honor Society Honors Diploma and Readiness Seal recipient, Jacob Michael Hawks. Jacob has a 4.45 GPA. He is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. He has an Ohio FFA state degree and has the following scholarships: Franklin B. Walter All Scholastic Award, South Central Power Academic Excellence Scholarship, Ohio Elks Association Most Valuable Student Scholarship, Pickaway County Council on Youth Leadership Scholarship, America's Farmers Grow Ag Leaders National FFA Scholarship, OSRBA Scholarship, Pickaway County 4-H Scholarship, Otterbein Presidential Scholar and Endowed Scholarships, Heber Masonic Lodge No. 501 Scholarship, Adam Carter Memorial Scholarship. Jacob is a Westfall FFA president, Future Farmers of Monroe 4-H president, member of the Quiz Bowl team, Pickaway County Junior Fair Board vice president, marching, jazz, and concert band, student council, and National Honor Society. Jacob will be attending Otterbein University, majoring in zoology and microbiology. Dalton Lee Helsel. Dalton attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for Outdoor Power Technologies. Dalton is an Honor Pin and four-year award recipient. and is a member of Skills USA. Dalton plans on becoming a firefighter after high school. Ethan Douglas Holman. Ethan is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Ethan ran varsity track and cross country and competed in BPA. Ethan will be attending Kent State University for construction management. Dalton Thomas Houtlin. Dalton has a 3.16 GPA. He is an Honor Pin recipient. Dalton attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for visual communication and design. Dalton is a member of the BPA, and his industry credentials are Adobe Certified Associate. Dalton is going to attend Columbus College of Art and Design and major in graphic design. Minor is not decided at this time. He received a scholarship from CCAD Discovery District Scholarship and the CCAD Institutional Grant. Ashley Renee Hunt. Ashley has a 3.21 GPA. She is an Honor Pin and four-year award recipient. Ashley will be attending Columbus State to further her career in veterinary medicine. Taylor Alexis James Elward. Taylor attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for visual communication and design. Taylor is a member of BPA and the MADE Drug-Free Club. Her industry credentials are Adobe Certified Associate. Taylor plans to attend college to study theater. National Honor Society member Braden Michael Johnson. Braden has a 4.2 GPA. He is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Braden is a four-year track and cross-country runner, two-year NHS member, one-year swim team member, two-year show choir member, one-year musical participation, 10-year 4-H participant, and local field hand and YMCA lifeguard. Braden is accepted to the Columbus State's Preferred Pathways Program. National Honor Society member and Readiness Seal recipient Hannah Gretchen Johnston. Hannah has a 4.11 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Hannah plans to attend Kentucky Christian University in the fall and major in elementary education and intercultural ministries. She has received the following scholarships: Kentucky Christian Lusby Scholarship, Kentucky Christian Alumni Scholarship, Kentucky Christian Covenant Church Scholarship, W.E.A. Vicki Cope, Linda Kempton Leduc Scholarship, and Turney and Lucille Rennick Scholarship. National Honor Society member and Readiness Seal recipient Julian Marie Jude. Julian has a 3.68 GPA. She has been accepted to Ohio State ATI and the University of Kentucky. She will be majoring in agri-science education, but is still unsure of which one she is going to attend. She is a FFA gold-rated treasurer. She is receiving the Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and 4-Year Award. She is also a member of the Drug Free Club of America and Prom Committee, co-treasurer of the Westfall FFA chapter, and president of the Barnyard Spitters 4-H Club. She is also a part of the Varsity Cheer Squad. National Technical Honor Society member, Gracie Taylor Keaton. Gracie has a 3.9 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and 4-Year Award recipient. Gracie attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center in Visual Communication and Design. She is a member of BPA, the MADE Drug Free Club, and her industry credentials are Adobe Certified Associate. She has been accepted into Columbus College of Art and Design and has been awarded the Discovery District Scholarship. National Honor Society member and Honors Diploma recipient, Madeline Joy Kitchen. Maddie has a 4.264 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and 4-Year Award recipient. Maddie will be attending Mount Vernon Nazarene University to run track and study Christian ministry. Maddie played varsity basketball, track, and soccer, was a member of the National Honor Society, Drug Free Club of America, Prom Committee, Allied Health, and Mount Sterling First Church of the Nazarene. Parker James Landefeld. Parker was a member of the varsity soccer and baseball teams, BPA, studio manager, show choir, and yearbook. Parker will be attending Ohio University to study to be a crime scene investigator. Isaac Dean Layton. Isaac attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for Law and Public Safety. He is a member of Skills USA and the MADE Drug Free Club. His industry credentials are chemical mace, taser, and first aid CPR. Hayden Nicholas Leemaster. Hayden has a 3.0 GPA, is an Honor Pin recipient. Hayden was a member of the varsity football, basketball, and baseball teams, and yearbook salesman. After high school, Hayden plans to attend the Ohio Fire Academy and begin his career in firefighting. Lucas Emery List. Lucas has a 3.0 GPA, is an Honor Pin recipient. Lucas was a varsity wrestling team member and varsity football. He was a BPA vice president and FFA member. And after high school, Lucas plans to attend culinary school. National Honor Society member and Honors Diploma recipient, Shelby Lynn Loudermilk. Shelby has a 4.128 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and 4-Year Award recipient. Shelby participated in varsity cheerleading, varsity track, National Honor Society, and prom committee. Shelby was accepted into Columbus State and Shawnee State and will be majoring in nursing. Megan Lynn Lowry. Megan has a 3.05 GPA, is a 4-year member of the Ag Department, and a four-year member of the band. Zachary Douglas Martin. Zach is an Honor Pin recipient and a member of the FFA state-winning AgriSphere Power Systems. His activities include soccer, marching and concert band, track, show choir, 4-H, St. Joseph Church Youth Group, and FFA. He was also one of the lead roles in the Footloose and Wizard of Oz musicals. Zach will be attending the University of Northwestern Ohio to get his Associate's in Robotics Engineering. Scrumpy Allen Massey. Scrumpy is an Honor Pin recipient. His activities include swing choir, concert choir, a cappella choir, church choir, marching band, concert band, Williamsport United Methodist Church Youth Group, and congregational care team. Scrumpy has been accepted to Ohio University Chillicothe, where he will be majoring in music therapy. National Honor Society Honors Diploma and Readiness Seal recipient Darby Lee Miner. Darby has a 4.35 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include NHS, FFA, 4-H, Junior Fair Board, Student Council, Prom Committee, DFCA, Trinity Lutheran Church Youth Group, Varsity Softball, Varsity Volleyball, Ohio Chill Travel Softball. Darby has been accepted to Huntington University and will major in occupational therapy and will also play on the university softball team. Her scholarships include Huntington University Softball Athletic Scholarship, Huntington University Presidential Academic School, and Red Cross Scholarship. National Honor Society and Readiness Seal recipient Riley Dean Miner. Riley has a 3.8 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Riley is a member of the FFA state-winning AgriSphere Power Systems and has the Ohio FFA state degree. Riley will be attending Columbus State and Ohio State for agricultural engineering. His activities include Pickaway Diablos Rifle Team, FFA, NHS, 4-H, Junior Fair Board, Pickaway County Junior Fair King, Trinity Youth Group, Trinity Mission Trip Team, and Varsity Cross Country. Chanston Tanner Mall. Chanston has a 3.21 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord and Honor Pin recipient. His activities include varsity football and wrestling, Drug-Free Club of America, Business Professionals of America. Chanston was accepted to the University of Akron and will be majoring in business administration. He will also be a part of the wrestling team. William Michael Morris. William is an Honor Pin recipient. His activities include varsity wrestling, football, and baseball. He was also a member of the e-sports team and a swing choir member for 3 years. William will be entering the National Guard in hopes of going to college to become a police officer. Edward Lee Muncy. Eddie attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for Law and Public Safety. Eddie is a member of Skills USA and the Made Drug-Free Club. His industry credentials are chemical mace, taser, first aid CPR, and NIMS 100, 200, 700, and 800. National Honor Society member, Bria K. Norris. Bria has a 4.071 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. She is a four-year member of the Marching and Concert Bands, section leader and first chair, two-year member of the NHS chapter, 3 years in the main office as an aide, former three-year member of the FFA chapter. Bria's plans are to major in audio engineering technology and obtain either an associate's or double major for business. Her scholarships include the Circleville Pumpkin Show Band Scholarship, the Pickaway Works Eula Jean Ader Metzler Scholarship, and the Turney and Lucille Rennick Scholarship. Jenna Marie Osborne. Jenna has been a member of the Marching Band and the Business Professionals of America. Jenna has also worked at McDonald's for the last 8 months. National Honor Society and Honors Diploma recipient, Lainey Renee Patterson. Lainey has a 4.305 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include varsity cheerleading, National Honor Society, prom committee, BPA, DFCA, and Westfall Cares. Lainey has been accepted to University of Cincinnati and Ohio University Chillicothe and is planning to major in early childhood education. Her scholarships include South Central Power Career Technical Scholarship, Monroe Alumni Association Scholarship, Shawnee Academic Excellence Award, and Heber Masonic Lodge No. 501 Scholarship. Xander Storm Pence. Xander has a 2.488 GPA. He is a member of the Business Professionals of America and has been hired to Fleek Brothers Farm Drainage. Keegan Patrick Powell. Keegan has a 3.3 GPA. He is a Gold Honor Cord and Honor Pin recipient. His activities include varsity baseball, basketball, 4-H, and yearbook. Keegan has been accepted into Columbus State Community College, where he will get his associate's degree in science. After Columbus State, he plans on transferring to The Ohio State University to obtain his bachelor's degree. Madison Dawn Rice, National Honor Society and Readiness Seal recipient. Madison has a 3.58 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include NHS, FFA, 4-H, marching band, concert band, choir, student council, Drug-Free Club of America, and prom committee. She also volunteers in many things such as Westfall Cares, Night to Shine, Party with a Purpose, and others. Madison has been accepted to Ohio University Chillicothe and will major in early childhood education. Faith Ann Robinson. Faith has a 3.52 GPA and is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. National Honor Society and Honors Diploma recipient, Emma Faith Rowe. Emma has a 4.12 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. She is a member of the National Honor Society, Student Council, Show Choir, A Cappella, Marching Jazz Band, Battle Over Books, Quick Recall, is the Business Professionals of America Secretary, Parley Pro Secretary, and would have played Glinda in The Wizard of Oz. She has been accepted to The Ohio State University and Ohio University, and she will be majoring in Chemical Engineering. Her scholarships include Ohio Distinction Scholarship, Ohio Success Scholarship, Ohio Pathway Scholarship, Russ Vision Scholarship, Turney and Lucille Rennick Scholarship, and the Judge William Amer Scholarship. Tyler Lee Ryan. Taylor Lane Ryan. Taylor has a 3.24 GPA, has attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for Health Science. Taylor is a member of Skills USA, and her industry credentials include first aid and CPR. Taylor has been accepted into Shawnee State, Southern State, and Columbus State. She will be majoring in social sciences. National Honor Society Honors Diploma and Readiness Seal recipient, Justin Craig Schobelock. Justin has a 3.99 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. He's also the National FFA Scholarship recipient, and his activities include marching, jazz, and concert band, National Honor Society, Future Farmers of America, Business Professionals of America, Drug Free Club of America, Student Council, member of the Parliamentary Procedure Teams, and Prom Committee. He has been accepted into The Ohio State University and majoring in Real Estate and Urban Analysis. Readiness Seal recipient, Jaden David Schooley. Jaden is also an Honor Pin recipient. His activities include varsity baseball, Columbus Sharks baseball, Drug Free Club of America, FFA, yearbook ad salesman, and welding class. Jaden plans to go straight into the workforce and do HVAC. He currently works at Hartsock Ag Farms. Natalie Lynn Seacrest. Natalie is an Honor Pin recipient. After high school, Natalie plans on getting a job at a zoo so she can eventually work her way up to a wildlife sanctuary. Natalie currently works at Wendy's. Ella Catherine Seeley. Ella has a 3.4 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include golf, track, student council, Big Brother, Big Sister, and mentoring kids at OCU. Ella has received a golf scholarship from Ohio Valley University, and she is going to major in secondary education. Honors Diploma recipient, Gavin Charles Selman. Gavin has a 4.08 GPA. He is also a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and 4-year award recipient. Trevor Wade Sharon. Trevor is an Honor Pin recipient and has been a career mentor for 2 years. Zachary Emerson Simmons. Zach has a 3.2 GPA, is an Honor Pin recipient, and plans on going right into work. He has done ag and went to Youngstown University for the I Believe Foundation. Caleb Michael Smith. Caleb attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for carpentry. He is a member of Skills USA, and his industry credentials include Career Connection Certificate Levels 1 and 2 and OSHA 10 and OSHA 30. After high school, Caleb plans to apply for an apprenticeship. Aurora Marie Sparks Stiers. Aurora is an Honor Pin recipient. She currently works at Bubba's Corner gas station, and her future plan is to work in the animal field. Connor David Spahn. Connor has a 3.2 GPA. He is an honor and 4-year award recipient. Connor played varsity baseball and varsity basketball, has been accepted to Ashland University, where he will be attending on a baseball scholarship. National Honor Society member Elizabeth K. Stonerock. Liz has a 4.4 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and 4-year award recipient. Her activities include varsity softball, National Honor Society, drug-free club, student council, club softball, volunteer Sunday school teacher, volunteer guidance office helper, and volunteer kindergarten aide. Liz will be attending Capital University in the fall, where she will play on the softball team and begin her journey towards a bachelor's in psychology. She has received the following scholarships: Capital Presidential Scholarship, Justin Butcher Memorial Fund Scholarship, and Leo Motes Scholarship. Honors Diploma recipient, Jarrett Colton Story. Jarrett has a 3.565 GPA. He is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and 4-year award recipient. His activities include drug-free club, yearbook, rec baseball and football officiating. His plans are to go to Columbus State, then transfer to The Ohio State University and major in criminology. Gage Michael Sturgill. Laney Jordan Swan. Laney has a 3.8 GPA. She is a gold honor cord and honor pin recipient. Her activities include varsity soccer, Spiketown Volleyball Club, basketball, and 4-H. After graduation, she plans to attend Morehead State University to study political science. From there, I hope to then attend law school. Honors Diploma recipient, Chloe Elizabeth Tandler. Chloe has a 3.9 GPA. She is a gold honor cord, honor pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include being captain of the girls' varsity soccer team, First Capital Football Club, member of Drug Free Club of America, Prom Committee, and Business Professionals of America. Chloe plans to go to University of Akron to study marketing management, also be a part of Akron's club soccer team. Jacob Michael Tennehill. Jacob's activities include FFA member for 3 years, BPA member for 2 years, varsity drone racing, and varsity esports team. Jacob plans on going straight to work and is going to try to do great things with his life. John Wesley Thomas III. Wes's activities include JV and varsity baseball, marching, concert, and jazz band, section leader. He has received the Mustang Award in 2018 and 2019 and was Student of the Month January 2020. Wes plans on going straight into the workforce after graduation. Parker Reed Thornton. Parker is an honor pin recipient. His activities include varsity golf, Drug Free Club of America, welding class, and FFA member. Parker's plans on going straight into the workforce, doing construction or electric. He currently works at Hartsock Ag. Sydney Jade Tenney. Sydney has a 3.5 GPA. Is a gold honor cord and honor pin recipient. Sydney's activities include playing varsity soccer, basketball, and softball. She joined the yearbook and prom committee and was a part of the Country Kids 4-H Club. Sydney will be attending OU Chillicothe for 2 years for human biology and then transferring to Ohio University for pediatrics. Destiny Nicole Tracewell. Throughout the school years, Destiny played football, basketball, softball, Muay Thai, and jiu-jitsu. Destiny loves to hunt and fish, and she will be attending Columbus State University. Destiny's plans are to get certified in professional dog training and eventually own her own business. Hunter Kane Vance. Hunter has a 3.1 GPA. He is an honor pin and four-year award recipient. He has been a member of the Honor Roll and part of the National Society of High School Scholars. Hunter has been accepted to Columbus State, Ohio Christian University, University of Kentucky, and Marietta. Hunter likes to help around the community and do volunteer work for his neighbors. Raylynn Sue Vance. Raylynn has received a Pell Grant to continue her education at Southern State in early childhood. She is currently a manager at Family Dollar. National Honor Society and Honors Diploma recipient, Emily Lynn Vaughn. Emily has a 4.3 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include cheerleading, track, student council, National Honor Society, Drug-Free Club of America, Skills USA, and sports medicine. Emily has been accepted to The Ohio State University, but is taking a semester or a year off to continue working full-time and saving money. Dakota Ryan Warren. Dakota is an Honor Pin recipient, has participated in Ag, earned Ohio FFA state degree, is also a member of BPA, and did a one-year career mentorship. Caleb Mitchell Washington. Caleb attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for carpentry. His industry credentials are Career Connection Certificates for Level 1 and 2 and OSHA 10. Caleb participated in Ag, was a member of BPA and the Made Drug-Free Club. He was 1 year in concert choir, 2 years in swing choir, and did a 1 year career mentorship. Joshua Joseph Curtis White. Josh has a 3.5 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. He has participated in basketball, Business Professionals of America, Future Farmers of America, powerlifting, and the Hype Squad. Josh will be attending Columbus State for his first 2 years of college and then transferring to The Ohio State University for the second 2 years, where he plans to receive his bachelor's degree in finance and accounting. National Honor Society and Honors Diploma recipient, Josie Nicole Williams. Josie has a 4.35 GPA. She is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include varsity softball, varsity volleyball, National Honor Society, Drug-Free Club of America, Prom Committee, Student Council, Ohio Chill Softball, Allied Health, externship through Berger Hospital as a patient care assistant. She will be attending Wright State University to major in nursing, and she is also a part of the Honors Program. Josie has received the following scholarships: Berger Hospital Gift Shop Scholarship, Donald H. Kempton Scholarship, Joshua R. Green Memorial Scholarship, UWPC Deputy Dale Thomas Community Impact Scholarship, Red Cross Scholarship, and Wright State Academic Scholarship. Olivia Jean Wright. Olivia attended Pickaway Ross Career and Technology Center for Health Science. She is a member of Skills USA and her industry credentials are first aid CPR and STNA. J. Allen Wyman. Jay has a 3.3 GPA. He is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Jay's activities include varsity basketball, varsity baseball, drug-free club, and hype squad. Jay will be attending Ohio University Chillicothe for 4 years and plans to study human biology. National Honor Society and Honors Diploma recipient, Madeline Elizabeth Yates. Madeline has a 4.35 GPA, is a Gold Honor Cord, Honor Pin, and four-year award recipient. Her activities include varsity soccer, National Honor Society, Drug-Free Club of America, Prom Committee, and First Capital Football Club. Madeline will be attending the University of Rio Grande in hopes of obtaining a Bachelor's of Science Diagnostic Medical Sonography, where she will also be playing soccer. She has received the following scholarships: South Central Power Roundup Scholarship, Rio Grande Athletic Scholarship, Edwin and Lola Red Storm Scholarship, and the Red Cross Scholarship. Serena Nicole Zarball. Serena has a 3.17 GPA, is an Honor Pin recipient. Serena has participated in cheerleading, BPA, and prom committee. Serena is currently employed at Donato's.
Members of the Board of Education, Mr. Dennis, and colleagues on the faculty and staff of Westfall High School, Middle School, and Elementary Schools, President and First Lady Trump, members of the Cabinet and Supreme Court, Governor DeWine, Dr. Acton, parents, grandparents, dear loved ones, special friends, and the class of 2020. Today, it is my special privilege to give a final address requested by no one to the 56th graduating class of Westfall High School, 3 days after they received their diplomas. The class of 2020 came into the world in the uncertainty and fear surrounding the terrorist attacks of September 11, 2001. Your parents were undoubtedly concerned about how the awfulness of that day might frame and shape the world into which they had brought their wonderful, beautiful bundles of joy. Yet they doted and corrected. Mom and Dad and probably many others dressed, fed, clothed, loved, and adored you. There were first teeth, steps, words, two-wheelers, and more. Then one day, you climbed onto that bus and headed into the big, bright new world of kindergarten. There were shapes, colors, music, letters, and numbers. There were new friends to make and sometimes lose. There was laughter and some tears. There were tests, first with pencil and then on computers. There were music and art recitals in the Kappa Gymatorium. Westfall Elementary formed a basis for learning and doing. Middle school brought the cliches of lockers and combinations you may or may not remember on any given day. There were new choices like band or choir or both. There was that final grasp at recess and a kind of growth and development you may only appreciate in the experiences of your own children someday. Then came the next transition, high school. Patrick, Hunter, Ashley, Luke, Darby, Riley, Laney, and Justin were just a few who started their first day at Westfall High School trying to find M1 for their first class. Some of you wanted to come back the next day. Others were less sure it was a good idea. Eventually, most decided it would be okay. You ran, golfed, took shots, wrestled, jumped, and kept your eye on the ball. You learned the periodic table and its purpose, mathematical functions, literature, oxyacetylene, and pastels for 4 short years. Special people came into your lives, and some left too early. You watched classes ahead of you pass through the doors one last time, and now it's your turn. It's easier to reach destination when you have a clear path and tools to overcome obstacles put before you. We here at Westfall have tried to provide as many tools as we could to make your path less bumpy. Some of you have a clear destination. Among you are carpenters, farmers, cosmetologists, bankers, teachers, engineers, welders, and hopefully an epidemiologist or two. Estimates are that for 60% of you, the profession you head toward does not yet exist. That's because you will create it. You will be the entrepreneurs who will invent the process or product we didn't know we wanted. Thank you in advance. Joseph Berg said the mind can only absorb what the seat can endure. Please remember this when you present the toast as best man or maid of honor in your best friend's wedding. The class of 2020 leaves Westfall amid as much chaos as when you entered this world. Perhaps look at the situation as an opportunity to make our world better, more loving, and peaceful for all. I give you my heartfelt congratulations on a job well done, but really only just begun, to borrow from the Carpenter's tune. I look forward to your continued success, and keep in touch with us if you can. Thank you. Congratulations. Well done.